finalist. Here comes Dynamite. Trier, hier kommt die Nummer 1 der Welt, der Grand Slam of Darts Champion und der aktuelle Champion of the World. It's Bully Boy, Michael Smith.
Into the second half of the evening session, and what a day it has been so far. The afternoon session certainly delivered, and so far in the evening session we have seen stories aplenty. The latest, of course, coming in the departure of the three-time European Darts Match Play champion Michael van Gerwen. But the focus now switches to the current world number one and the current world champion Michael Smith, a winner on the European Tour already this year, a winner on the Pro Tour as well. And having had a little bit of a breather from the European stage, he is back with us. He was a quarter-finalist in Visa in his most recent European Tour event. And, significantly perhaps tonight, we'll be keeping an eye on the ammunition as well, because he's throwing a new set of weaponry as he prepares to take on Dynamite Keane Barry, one of the most exciting young talents in the world, and there are plenty of them as well for company. Just 21 years of age, Keane Barry celebrated his 21st fairly recently, in fact, as well.
Ladies and gentlemen, first leg is Michael to throw first. Game on!
A player who has come of age in more ways than one, I think it is fair to say, Paul Nicholson.
Yeah, the fact that he is 21 is laughable, because it feels like he's been around forever. But let's talk about the weaponry, because I love the way you put that, by the way. I've never heard it called ammunition. That's definitely going to catch on. This is the new dart. This is the new weaponry for Michael Smith. Now that he's gone with a new manufacturer, I was just having a chat with you off the air as to why said manufacturer is probably gone all in on Michael Smith. They want him to be their Michael Jordan. If you go back to the 1980s and you see a very swooshy brand trying to make a name for themselves in the shoe market, they went all in on Michael Jordan. What this brand have done is they've said to Michael, we want you to be our guy. And it'll be interesting to see just how long it takes for Michael to break these in, because his previous set, they had age. They had experience, and they should now be put into a museum because they've done an awful lot.
Yeah, he's clearly their marquee signing, isn't he? Michael Smith has put plenty on social media about this new set of silverware that he's got at his disposal, and so far it's serving him fairly well. He's down to a finish of 67, although Barry's waiting in the wings just in case. But double 20 is found, and Michael Smith kicks off with a 67 checkout for a 1-0 lead.
Do you know what? I'm a bit old school when I say this, but looking at Michael Smith using different equipment, it just feels weird because you can almost close your eyes and think, well, Smithy's just using the same stuff. He never thought of changing kit until this deal came around. And quite frankly, that first leg tells us that he's very comfortable with them. So that's pretty much all we should say on the matter. But they are very pretty.
Yeah, and I suppose from Smith's point of view, it's all about taking that next step. He's obviously not resting on his laurels. I mean, since becoming the world champion, he's produced the goods, as I've said, winning that Pro Tour title, winning a European Tour title as well. And so clearly he sees this as another addition to his game plan in terms of his immediate future and, and the incremental changes that he can make.
Correct. We saw Adrian Lewis win his first world title. Then, in the middle of the next season, change manufacturers. Then he defended the world championship with a different brand. So maybe Bully Boy is about to do the same in the next 6 or 7 months. But his immediate thing on his radar is to try and topple Keane Barry. And he might take a 2-0 lead with a big
28.
Out.
28. Michael 145.
Inevitably, I mean, if Michael Smith were to lose this match, let's just see if he can take out this 145, he can't. If he were to lose this match, I can bet your bottom dollar that on social media, people will be saying, it's the new darts, go back to the old.
Yeah.
Don't tinker.
Two twos.
Cash on the second
well done, Keane. There's going to be a lot of focus on Michael Smith in this game. We can't forget the fact that Keane Barry has already disposed of Kim Huybrechts in this tournament, putting Kim in the bubble position for the world match play. As far as Keane's concerned, because of the elimination of Ricardo Pietrechko now, he's the next on the chopping block. If he loses, he's out of the match play race. But it's not just about tonight. Keane needs to make the final if he's going to gate crash the Winter Gardens.
And pretty sure he'll have had a look at the draw bracket and he will know that if he does win this, if he does beat the world number one, he's got the small matter of Josh Rock, the number 10 seed to face in the third round tomorrow afternoon in the last 16.
It doesn't tend to get any easier.
It doesn't. I mean, things do work out. I mean, we've had rare examples where the draws are kind, or on paper at least. I mean, darts isn't played on paper, as we know.
433.
Barry competing in just his fourth European Tour event of this year, however. I mean, the road to Blackpool would have been made a lot smoother had he qualified for a few more. But he has made the quarterfinals in two of the other three, so when he has been involved, he's often made good progress.
How does he hit this? It's a half a ball to aim at.
92.
Might have even had less.
64.
Missed darts at the bullseye for a 2-1 lead and a break of throw. Tops for Smith.
Cash on third leg, Michael Smith.
I think Michael Keane understands just how dangerous Keane is. You mentioned those quarter-final runs of Keane Barry. There's a lot of respect between these two. When Michael was Keane's age, there was a lot of pressure on his shoulders to be the player that he is now. He has succeeded. And 59. I don't think we're putting as much pressure on Keane in the same vein, but he has done his best work on the big stage this year. In fact, his best 81. Runs have all come on the European Tour.
Yeah, the good omen here for Michael Smith is that in winning the German Darts Grand Prix earlier this year on the European Tour, he beat Keane Barry on the way in the quarterfinals by 6-4 as well. That's their only meeting this year. They did meet three times last year. And Barry did win one of those. It was a first-round match at one of the early Pro Tours, but the biggest match of the lot was that UK Open semi-final, which Smith won by 11-6.
140. Keane Barry 170.
And they also met in the Hungarian Darts Trophy a couple of years ago as well. So these two have crossed
58
paths before on a European Tour stage.
Not that I'm trying to get ahead of myself, but I'm already looking forward to Hungary, because that is a real hotbed now for the European Tour. Yeah, one stop a year in Budapest and it's well worth it.
Yeah, it's a nice time of year as well. Just late summer, creeping into autumn.
80.
Double 16 can't be found there for Keane Barry. Michael Smith with a good opportunity for the first break of throw. Treble 18. Single for 20 for tops.
Yeah, it's on the fourth leg.
Well,
Michael
you look at the three legs that he's won. Those
fifth leg is Michael Michael to throw first.
That bracket, 67, 64 and 78, and Michael Smith has hoovered up every single one of them, and just look at the numbers on the finishing as well. 3 from 3 so far, whereas Keane Barry is 1 from 7.
And he has had a 6 from 6 on a European Tour stage before in Graz. It's a few years ago now, though, but this is a really encouraging start for the world champion and world number one. What I'm not seeing so far is that ease of scoring power with the new equipment, but the doubles look really good.
Yeah, 1 from 7 for Barry, but 5 of those attempts were in one leg in the second, so that slightly doesn't... Well, it slightly distorts the statistic.
Here you see the angle of entry for Keane. He is probably the world's best when it comes to a fast skidding dart.
Au
contraire for Michael Smith, who gets them to stack underneath with that upright angle of attack. But look at these skidding. Skids off the barrel just like that with pace.
140. It's likely require 81.
Almost hypnotic to watch if you're a darts geek like me.
55.
First miss a double for Smith.
121.
Well, he won't be 6 from 6 tonight. Keane Barry looking to hit back with 1-2-1, and he may well do so. Bullseye.
96.
Yeah, once again, he missed the bullseye in leg 3, 26. And he's missed it again in leg 5.
Statistically, this is the second most neglected double on the board.
On the fifth leg,
but
Michael
it's a double that gives him a 4-1 lead. Looking comfortable, averaging over 100. And double 13 is only ever really left when someone's got 62 and they get the treble 12. Or, say, a 1-4-6 checkout where they get two of what Michael's just hit there.
430 bar.
Well, 4-1, but it is just one break, and that's one crumb of comfort for Barry. The other is that had he hit those two darts at bullseye, he would have been 3-2 up.
140.
I think the trouble is he needs to be giving himself better opportunities than darts at the bull. You know, these last-ditch flings of the dice. So
50.
You can read that one of two ways, I suppose, but Michael Smith, you'd rather be in his shoes right now.
91.
Yeah, 4-1 up, playing well, and you have to see it. He can score better than this, but his approach play and his doubling has been very good.
Just in terms of the physical characteristics of these new darts as well, what's your immediate observations?
Well, apart from them being very pretty, I think the thing about these compared to his old ones is that these look shiny. His other ones had a sort of matte effect on them because they'd been worn down over years. I wouldn't be surprised if he sticks with this kit for a period of years, and it'll take about 2 years for them to get down to the kind of feel that he wants.
Tops he wants here.
62.
That's another missed answer. Keane
Uruguay, 16.
So missed opportunity for the break. Keane Barry for the hold of throw, looking at 3 clear darts at double 8, and he only needs the 1.
Some legs, Michael to throw first. Game.
There's more grooves on them as well. If you put them next to his old ones, there's a lot more technology, a lot more intricacy on those barrels than the previous ones.
And to the layman out there, people like me as well, I mean, grooves equals what in terms of aerodynamics?
Grip technology, that's what it's all about. It's how deep the grooves are, how it feels in the fingertips or in the palm of the hand.
60.
Sometimes is it likely they're the same weight as the ones he had before, though?
Incredibly likely. He'll want to use a new piece of equipment, but he won't want it to be drastically different.
Yeah.
He'll want it to showcase what he wants to do moving forward. More of that is what he wants.
Clearly been putting them to good effect on the practice board as well. Michael Smith
140.
Down to 1-2-1. Barry applying the pressure as he looks for the Baker throw. 101, treble 17, bullseye with Barry lurking.
96.
This time it's Smith who misses
87.
The dart at the bullseye.
I have to say that maybe this has to go. Miss this. And he has missed it.
Well, that is pretty unforgivable. I mean, he was needing 70. At least give himself a shot at the bullseye. Okay, he's missed
37.
Two bullseyes already, but at least it's a chance.
25.
But no chance forthcoming after that stray dart into the treble one. And Here we go, double 10 for a 5-2 lead. Double 5, yeah. Excellent marker, wasn't it? Just brushed that flight on the way through.
And Keane to throw first.
Yeah, Keane. Real lesson learned there for Keane Barry.
He might have changed the kit today, but the game plan hasn't changed. It's still 5, double 10 for 25. And we've talked at length before about that single 5 being in the way of double 5 if he needs it, but sometimes it can give you a nice flick on at the front post. 5-2 is a fair reflection here, but even Keane's averaging over 102. He's not doing a great deal wrong. He's just not hitting doubles when he gets there.
Yeah, and again, Keane Barry, one of these players looking to claw their way into the European Championship picture. And you know what? I think he might almost be there, you know. Because he was on 14 and a half prior to this weekend. So second round money, assuming he does lose this one. That will put him, I think, almost on the cusp.
99.
Michael Smith currently 8th on the European Tour order of merit with £52,000 before this weekend.
Yeah, he'll be fine.
105. Can you go 152?
He will definitely be in Dortmund. And Michael could be in the next round in the next three darts.
83.
And Brendan Dolan would be very close to the match player if this goes.
Well, Michael Smith, perhaps a chance now to finish with the biggest checkout of the match, but it's not going to be easy.
Keane Uruguay, 69.
78, the biggest checkout of the match so far. Keane's biggest, 16. Is that about to change?
37.
It isn't.
Michael Uruguay, 56. Fancy
the hammer might be put down now on Keane's challenge for this title.
14 data incoming, 16 for tops for the world champion and the world number one. And the new ammunition serves him well in its first outing here on the European Tour. An average of 101.1 as well to boot. Michael Smith, 6 out of 10 on the doubles. Plenty to admire about the way he went about his business in that one. And Michael Smith...